Thank you. rising Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. We know that in the life of Jacob, Christ clothed Jacob with his love. So in Christ, may Jacob be clothed with glory. Here and now, dear friends, we are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. Friends, we have gathered here to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Jacob Wilson. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace, that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow, hope, and in death, resurrection. O God, who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death. And help us to live as those who are prepared to die. And when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in you. And that nothing in life or in death will be able to separate us from your great love. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. First of all, I want to thank the Wilson family for the sharing of their love and remembrances of Jacob with me yesterday. You can tell that there was so much love being expressed for the life force that Jacob was in their life. And for the love he shared with friends, family, but especially the love he had for his family. I have known the Wilsons for nearly 36 years. And one thing that has always been constant for as long as I have known them is the strong bond and the connection that they have for each other and for family. Jacob, in so many ways, embodied that familial bond. As we said yesterday, Jacob was the glue guy for the family. I really began to see in my mind a picture of Jacob, in which it seemed as if there were no family distinction with any of his relatives, just one big happy family. A family he loved with all his heart and with all his might. A family he was proud of and proud to be a part of. During our conversation, several Bible verses came up in the conversation, and one of the verses mentioned came from Matthew 25, the 21st verse, where the gospel writer proclaims and offers a proclamation made by Jesus through one of his parables. sure this passage came to mind because Jacob had loved others so well and did so with a servant heart. But I want to take just a little personal liberty and read more of the passage because I think it speaks to the kind of person that Jacob certainly was. For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his servants and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1. And this is an important part. To each according to his ability. Then he went away, and the one who had received 5 talents went off at once and traded them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had 2 talents made 2 talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came and settled accounts with him. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. Master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy servant. You have been trustworthy in a few things, and I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master's home. You see, I believe that God has blessed us with a lot of friends in our life. Many of them are simply just good friends in which we enjoy a very casual relationship. God also blesses us with some very good friends. Those we share much in common with, those we enjoy spending time with and love and seek out in both good times and bad times. But there are just a few of those very special friends that God blesses us with that impacts our lives. That changes our lives, that make us better and stronger just by their presence. They love us and they share themselves with us in very special and meaningful ways. And Jacob was one of those very special blessings to his family and friends. You see, Jacob had many talents, not like the talents of money in the parable, but the life-sharing, life-giving talents of love. Invested those talents well. Multiplying all that he had and all that he gave by sharing his love for life and for others. And I know that was pleasing to God, that he would be a blessing in that way. But speaking with the family, words like kind, spirited, loving, and fun-loving, consistent, constant, sentimental, as Roger would share that Jacob was sentimental to the point of keeping an old work shirt of his. And he kept his baseball shirt for when he was 8 or 9 years old. And he amassed a wonderful collection of racing helmets. Other words that came to mind were patient, sidekick, as Eric would say, especially when riding motorcycles or breaking bones. Eric also shared that he cherished the highs when him and Jacob would slow down and relax and just enjoy each other's company. Brother Bear, as Megan will recount, never letting silly rivalries get in the way. Example, our teacher, always being looked up to and followed, even when a bit getting locked in the trunk of a car. Isn't that right, Patrick? Always close, caring, calm, open, best hair in the family. Uncle Jakey, he always wanted to be with his nieces and nephews and they wanted to be with him. As Lindy was saying, he was just a big old kid. I could go on and on and on. And I just talked to a few members of his immediate family. I am certain that the extended family would echo all of these remembrances, an expression of the love that Jacob was. So many great memories, so many heartfelt memories shared during our conversation. What a great love it was that was shared freely and completely. But Jacob's love wasn't reserved just for his family, it was offered to his friends as well, as evidenced by all who are here today. To know Jacob was to love Jacob and count him as one of your very special friends that I mentioned earlier, because that is the way that he loves you. You see, Jacob was, he was an all-in kind of guy. There seemed to be no halfway with him, no matter what he did, no matter what was going on. It was almost overwhelming to see all of the responses close to the face of the following the announcement of Jacob's death. And let me tell you, all of you who were friends with Jacob and offered your expressions of love, it brought so much comfort and offered so much support to Jacob's family. You surrounded him with your love, a love that was rooted in the love you shared with Jacob. It meant so much to all of them. Perhaps it was best said by one of Jacob's friends, Stormy Hood. These are her words. A couple of words left out. Almost all her words. We meet so many of these amazing people on our journey. That if we're lucky, we meet someone like Jacob Wilson. Myself and others are so blessed we had Jacob in our lives. Jacob's journey was too short. And for that, I'm sad, upset, mad, angry, just a full range of emotions. That's just me being selfish and grieving for his amazing family. With that being said, on his short journey, he lived like most of us never have and never will. With his infectious personality, you wanted to be around him. You wanted to be his friend. You wanted to be part of his life. And he did just that. He made everyone he crossed paths with be a part of his life. There are so many of us that are better for having Jacob in our life. He made you smile, cry with laughter, and pee in your pants if you didn't pay attention. We're going to miss you is a complete understatement. To my friend that was a one-man lead worldwide, to the guy who randomly ran up behind and touched those luscious locks, I told you he had good hair. They get a hug that was genuinely true. Both in this so incredibly much. I think those words are a true and loving expression of a friend and family and four friends and family alike. I'm thinking about Jacob. But it's also the part of him that will never leave you. Your memories, the part of him that is a part of you, those things will be with you forever. They will never, ever leave you. Any of you. I don't know if you noticed or not, but the word love has been used a lot. These words of remembrance. I would like to close with this. Eric shared that Jacob had recently shared with him that he was as content in life as he had ever been. I want to believe that the contentment came from loving others and from being loved. Jacob's grandfather Curtis was proudly commenting a couple weeks ago how much joy it brought him to have his family love each other and to be so close. Curtis, that's on you and Nana and Sherry. Because I believe with all my heart the people who love wood do so because they are taught. Jacob and the rest of your family are at this as well. And I know that when Jacob passed through heaven's gate, his Lord and Master God greeted him with a well done, good and trustworthy servant. You entered into the joy of your master's home. Thanks be to God for the life Jacob was.
Gone, I won't see you. It feels like change.
us seek now the words of comfort that we find in Scripture. And let us first go to a very familiar passage you'll see printed in your bulletin. It is the Psalm 23. Now I invite you to say it with me as we join together in one voice. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Our New Testament passage, the first one comes from Philippians. Fourth chapter, verses 4 through 7. This is what it says. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known. And the peace of God will surpass all understanding. Will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And this next passage comes from 1 Thessalonians. Again, the 4th chapter, beginning with the 13th verse. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so through Jesus God will bring with him those who have died. And our final New Testament lesson comes from the Gospel of John, the selected passages from the 14th verse. I invite you to stand in body or in spirit for the reading of John's Gospel. Jesus said to them, let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. And because I live, you also will live. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks
be to God.
Please. I think this is one of the most reassuring passages in all of Scripture. I love these verses that come from John's Gospel. Jesus tells us as he is preparing his disciples for his eventual death on Jesus says, do not let your hearts be troubled. I think it's a little easier said than done on a day like today. But he reassures us that if we believe in God and believe that we believe also in him, that he is going to a place that there are many, many, many dwelling places. A place we know is heaven. And he reassures us that if it were not so, but he had told us this. And when he had told us that he goes to prepare a place for us, because see, this begins the understanding of our hope and our salvation. Because Jesus tells his disciples, and he tells us, he reassures us that if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. And I will take you to myself. So that where I am, you may be also. John talks in another scripture account attributed to him about this place that we will go to be with Jesus, about heaven. And John recounts through his revelation that heaven is a place in which we will stand in the presence of God. That is what we celebrate this day. That Jacob stands in the presence of God. And it will be God who will wipe away every tear in Jacob's eye. It will be God who will wrap his loving arms around Jacob and welcome him to his eternal home. It will be God that will heal Jacob and reunite him with all those who have gone before him. It is Jacob who is now at rest in the heavenly home. Because Jesus promises us that he will come again and take us to be with him. And he reassures us that we know the way to the place where we are going. He's not going to leave us alone. God's presence will always be with us. I'm coming to you, he says. You that are in this world will no longer see me, but you will know that I'm there. We sense God's presence among us. Love and support that we feel in our family, with our friends, and all those who love us. God is making his presence known to us through the people he places in our lives. And again, reassures us that because he lives, we also Jesus goes on to remind us that he has said these things to us while he was still with us. But just know that the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, and the Father will send by name will remind us of all that we were, of all that has been made known to us. And then these words that close this passage, it means so much. I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. This is a different kind of peace. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. For I am with you. Hear those words again. My peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. We pray to you for one another in our need, in and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. And to all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold on to one another. In all your ways we trust you. And to you, with your church on earth and in heaven, we offer honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Roger, to you and all of your family, please know that we will continue to be in prayer for you and prayer with you. We love you, and we hold you close, as will all those who have been. I hope that you find strength and peace in that. Following the benediction, I will ask the congregation to please stand while the family remains seated. And after the closing voluntary, the congregation is dismissed. We will close the sanctuary doors and reserve a time of prime time for the family. So hear now the words of this benediction. Now may the God of peace, who brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you complete in everything good, so that you may do his will, working among us that which is pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. The congregation will please stand.
Thank you.
Amen. What a wonderful way and a wonderful service. God bless you all. Thank you so much for your love and your presence.